Teddy sits.
How many wings you got?
I got 10.
Fried? What about you?
I got the sandwich. I hadn't tried it before as well. Why didn't pull the trigger back?
You know what the taste
is? Right. It was just that bread was so... I don't know what type of bun that was, but...
It wasn't Cane's.
Bro, we need a sandwich out of this toast right here.
Bro, that thing's fire.
Bro, this toast is so good.
My drug.
Thank God I don't live next to a Cane's.
They're opening a
Cane's
and Compton right there on Target set.
Oh,
people about to die, dude. Diabetes about to...
They're gonna, a gang is gonna like, you know, like claim it. They're like, this Cane's is mine.
My gang, yeah. The gang is mine.
I'm dead. You gotta be a prick to come to this Cane's.
Go to the one on Tweety.
Pick those in.
No, blue. That's blue.
Everyone. Go to the one on Tweety. Don't be coming
out here. I'm dead.
All the workers are gang members.
Let's go to Bane's.
Let's go to Bane's. pull up the bangs real quick. Can I get some bacon?
Whose water is this?
Get the Baniac combo.
The Baniac combo?
That's crazy.
How's life
going? That's great, dude. My boy's thriving for sure. You thriving?
Thriving to what?
You thriving. Is it recording right now?
Oh, I'm getting up that whole session.
Oh. Oh my God.
I'm posting it. Y'all racist mother.
Then we're gonna get canceled, bro. I'm about to lose all my clothes. Jersey.
Go for it.
You're
saying
everybody?
I was saying how, like, yeah, I think you're gonna end up like, oh, you're
gonna
like,
oh, Jenny, make it happen.
God bless you. Good game,
Vanessa. We got it. Good playing with you. Good playing with you. Bye bye.
Probably.
Yes.
Bro, this song used to be like my theme song right there.
You're good.
You got it. Be ready for Sunday, next one. Or next one after that.
Pops, damn.
You got it.
Just watch him back now.
Come on, Zeke, I want you to talk. I want you to stop.
I was watching the game right there. Mm-hmm. What you want to talk about?
Black people.
Hmm?
Just go for it. Okay. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, and good night to whoever's watching right now. It is Tuesday, June 11, 12:43 in the morning. I am a little bit later than usual, and it is a Tuesday morning. I usually work out Monday night, which is anywhere from 10 or 11. So I'm roughly an hour and a half late, just because I did start my day late today. Today was my second day off of work. I woke up around 11 in the morning. From there, I made breakfast, and then I was supposed to go wash clothes around 1:30, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. But one of my really close friends, which is honestly one of my best friends, I would say, because I have like one or two best friends that I consider like friends that have been with me for a very long time. He hit me up and wanted to play pickleball, so we played pickleball for like 3 hours straight. I remember going to the park around like 1:32, and we were there till like 5 o'clock. So we were there for a good solid like 3 hours just playing pickleball. I had a great time, honestly. It's just that I am a bit tired now that I did got some cardio in. But yeah, we played pickleball for a good roughly 3 hours. We had a good time. And then from there, what we do? Well, I went to go see my sister at work, at Panda. So she hooked it up, obviously. Shout out to my sister. Love you, sis. I ate Panda. I did that. And then, did you guys know that they have a hot orange chicken? It was actually really good. I actually like them more than the regular orange chicken, just because I do like spicy food. But yeah, as you can tell from my face, again, chubby brodies. I got me the bigger plate, so I got me 3 entrees with the rice, and yeah, I got a crazy amount of protein there. I got double terry with some hot orange, and I got a scoop and a half of rice, of fried rice. I love fried rice. I always liked this since I was young, and yes, I know the white rice will be better, but honestly, bro, I gotta rock with my fried rice. I love fried rice, guys. So that was my order. And then from there, shout out to my brother. He let me wash clothes in his house. So I went to go see my brother. We talked about Father's Day plans, because Father's Day, it's this Sunday. So I'm looking forward to it, you know, finally spending time with my old man, like going out and to eat. We really don't do that. Like the last time we went out to eat with my old man, was his birthday. I remember we went to Lucille's, and honestly, it was great. And my dad is the type of guy that he does not like going out, and it's a very, very rare occasion when he does go out. So yeah, for Father's Day, I hope all of us, me, my brother and sister, could you know, put our differences aside so we could hang out with my pops. You know, I love my dad, I love my mom, you know, I love my mom so much that I hope I get to live with her one day, you know. But I have my dad close to me right now, so I am trying to get as much you know, time with my dad, because I don't know how much time I got left with my pops, you know. Thankfully he is healthy. I hope he's healthy. He hasn't went to the doctors in a very long time, but I do hope he's healthy. And, you know, any day he could leave this world. So my goal is to cherish the time with not only him, but my mother too. I just want to cherish their time here, you know, because one day they're going to be gone. And instead of feeling sad, instead of feeling depressed that they're gone, you know, I want to mourn them the day they leave. And I want to mourn them until a solid week to a month. I don't know how long it's going to take me to literally get over it. But I am preparing myself for it. And the way I'm preparing myself for one day one of my parents could leave this world is to really enjoy their time here. Like really, truly enjoy talking to them, listening to their story, and just being there and being present, and just really cherish the little moments, you know, the times I'm able to wake up and see my father, and I'm able to, you know, talk to my mom on the phone before work. I love talking to my mom, you know, a good 30 minutes a day. I really do try to talk to my mom and just even hear her voice, or even her when she's breathing. I really do enjoy that. You know, I try to be as close as possible to my parents, because I do not know when the last day I'm going to be alive, or my siblings are going to be alive, or, you know, my parents, you know. I really cherish those 4 people, you know. We all were together in life, bro. It was literally us 5. And I cherish those times we spent together, and I'm always going to cherish them no matter what happens in my life, no matter if I do disappear to a different country for a little bit and just, you know, try to really enjoy life. I do want to cherish every single moment with them. And that's what God allows me to do, you know, like really opening myself up to God and just, you know, talking to him and letting him know, like, I'm really super grateful that I'm able to have these moments and times and memories with them. And that's what I'm able to do. Just really sit in the moment and enjoy their presence. I really, really do love that. So, yeah, Sunday, hopefully we all get together and spend it. Hopefully, you know, that's what I really want, because obviously my siblings, they really, I wouldn't say they don't get along, because they're adults, but you know, they got their back and forths, and I do understand with siblings that, you know, we're not not every single time we're gonna see eye to eye. I wouldn't even say I as a middle child, I really do try to, you know, be neutral. I really just want to love them, bro. That's all I want to do, you know. Whatever differences they got, that's on them. But I really just try to be neutral and just try to love both of them, man. Honestly, that is my goal as a middle child and just as the middle brother. It's just to love them and their differences, because, you know, everyone is different. But yeah, guys, hopefully we will do that. I'm also going to give my dad flowers, you know. I'm looking forward to that. It's not gonna be crazy flowers. It's probably gonna be something like a Mexican down the street, you know, or next to the freeway selling those flowers. I'm probably gonna cop that. I just wanna give my dad like, hey, bro, like, hey, dad, like, here are your flowers. I wanna give you them before the day you pass, you know, because he never received flowers. So I really do wanna do that for my pops, you know. Also, I'm probably gonna buy him some Young LA sweats. The reason why is because I actually bought some Young LA sweats not that long ago, and he was seeing me wearing them. He was like, "Oh damn, that's pretty fire!" And the ones I'm talking about is the uncuffed or the not cuffed sweats, bro. Like the really baggy ones. He fucks with them, so I don't like buying shit. I really don't. But I seen those sweats and I was like, I gotta cop them just because one of my boys got sponsored. So I just try to support him. I use his code, and shout out to my boy Jizzy. I have a few friends in Young LA. You know, I got my boy Quave. I got my boy Cortez, Juan Cortez, Peachy. Love that guy. Brian Lopez. He's sponsored by them. Jizzy, pretty really cool guy. You know, I fuck with him too. There's so many that I fuck with that they got sponsored by Young LA, and I really do try to at least support one like once a month, just because, you know, they're my boys, and even though I don't got money like that, I really do try to support them, you know. They're my boys. And but yeah, so he was eyeing me when I was wearing it, you know. I was checking him out. He's like, yeah, fuck with that. So I'm probably gonna buy one or two sweats for him from my pops. I might steal them. I'm not sure, but I'm probably gonna buy that from my pops and his flowers, and probably we're gonna go to eat, have a good time, and probably a cake, a small cake for all of us, all four of us, because my mom is not here. My mom lives in Chicago, so obviously she's not gonna be there. So it's gonna be for four of us, just a small cake, a little piece that we could eat, and really enjoy that time with my dad, man, because we're not gonna have that many moments left, bro. My dad is old. He is like over his 60s, and yeah, guys, like us four are not gonna be together, you know, trying to celebrate it every single time, you know. So yeah, guys, that is the plans. But today, overall, I did the pickleball. After pickleball, I went to Goya with my sister and Panda. After that, I went to Walmart right away because they were gonna close. I'm sorry, I didn't go to Walmart. I went to go wash clothes at my brother's house. So I was there for like from 6 to 9 washing clothes, and then from there I went to Walmart right away because they were gonna close. I bought my food for the week, and then I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I was getting hungry again. My fat was getting hungry, and I seen a burrito, not a burrito spot, but like a taco stand right outside of Walmart. So I was like, fuck it, because I'm not gonna lie to you guys, my fat ass wanted Dave's Hot Chicken. I'm not gonna lie, I was wanting to probably get some two chicken sandwiches. I was on my way over there just because Dave's Hot Chicken is not that far away from the Walmart that I go to. But I was like, fuck it, let me just be a Mexican beaner today. And I got me a burrito. I got me a burrito con asada. Got it con todo, con frijoles y arroz y poquito chile, you know, cilantro, cebolla. I got all the mix, guys. So that was a fire-ass burrito because I got half asada, half pastor. Fuck, bro, that was so good, man. Juicy-ass burrito. Probably one of the best burritos I had in a while. And I had burritos. But this one was pretty top tier. So I gotta give that burrito like a good 8 out of 10. 8 is pretty solid as for a burrito too, man. So yeah, that's what I did, guys. I ate that. I went home, then ate it. I wasn't a fat ass and ate it in my car. No. I waited to go home, put my stuff there, all my clothes back to the house. Put my groceries away. Then I ate my burrito. You know, I'm not that fat. I'm pretty fat, and I got fat tendencies, but at heart, I'm a skinny guy, guys. Come on. I'm just bulking, bro. Trust the bulk. We're like less than 6 months away for us for this cut. And, you know, we just got to keep pushing, man. Honestly, that's just it. We just got to keep pushing, brothers. Like, we just got to keep striving to just keep showing up and not fucking give up, bro. Honestly, like, it was so hard for me to even come today to the gym. Again, there's no motivation, nothing in my mind. It's just straight discipline. And just calling myself a pussy until I come to the gym. Like, hey, pussy, come to the gym. Stop backing out. Stop fucking making excuses. Go, pussy. Go, 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 go. And that's what we did. We're right outside the gym. We're about to get this chest workout. Again, this is my first workout of the week. So we got to push hard, man. We really do. I wouldn't say tired. I'm just sleepy, bro. I'm just really am. But you know, we got to say fuck all that and just show up. So we're here. We're going to show up. We're going to change the attitude as soon as we go in. We got abs. We're going to get that out the way. And then from there, we got chest. I was thinking of doing incline bench press. But I was like, you know what? It's been a while since I used the dumbbells. So we're probably going to rock the dumbbells, especially we're going to probably rock the 100s. Today and just focus on just pushing that weight, and we're trying to get a good like solid 10 to 12 reps for 3 sets, so that's gonna be pretty sick, guys, to get up. After that, obviously we got some chest flies, but we're first gonna try some chest flies, some dumbbell incline presses, and from there we're gonna rock with two or three machines, and from there, you know, do triceps. We do got cardio. We got 30 minute cardio today, so we're gonna get that out the way too. I washed my hair today, so that was pretty chill. And then what was one last thing happened? I watched a new anime today. I started Windbreaker. It's a new anime, and I'm not gonna lie to you guys, the anime kind of reminded me of Tokyo Revengers without the like the teleporting and shit. And if I spoiled it for you guys, you know, it's all bad because, bro, it's been like a year or two since it came out. So y'all need to fucking catch up, bro. If you haven't watched it, that's your fault, not mine. But Windbreaker, I think there's barely 10 episodes. I don't know how many episodes are there. I don't even know the manga finish and all that. But Windbreaker was pretty good. I just don't like the too much. Trust me, I watch over like 70 plus animes. And I really don't like when the MC is like just super fucking loud. Like, don't get me wrong. I know they're gonna be over dramatic and they're the ones really carrying the whole show. But like when it's like fucking just screaming your ass off the whole time, I'm like, dog, like you is fucking weird. Naruto, don't get me wrong. That motherfucker just screams out. But the story is good. The story is really good, man. And it's fucking long. So I had to keep up with it. And eventually, you know, he slowed down a little bit. He's not that loud anymore. Slowly throughout the end of the Shippuden. But yeah, and also like Asta from fucking Black Clover. Yeah, like brother, all he does is fucking shout. But brother, the story's good. The story's really good, bro. And Windbreaker, that fucker is just way too loud, but there's only 10 episodes so far, so hopefully he slowly comes down. But great anime. I didn't think it would be that good, but it was pretty solid. I just started watching another one, which is a stupid ass anime, but I'm just intrigued in it just because, I'm not gonna lie, I'm already caught up with like almost any anime that you can think of that is coming out with a new season or or everyone just watching. I've been watched those, and then I'm just waiting for them. But this new anime is called, I don't even think it's new, it's been there for a while. It's Konosuba, God's Blessing in This Wonderful World. It's like one of those where you die in the real world and you just reincarnate, or you just go to a different world and you know, you overpower it and shit. So I just started that one. It's pretty cool. It's pretty dumb and funny. So, you know, that's going to get me out throughout the next few days, you know, just because work is going to be pretty boring. Hopefully, you know, it comes up, you know, with work, actually. But it does get boring, and I'm still learning Japanese. That is getting slowly better. I am going to push my Japanese this week. But, yeah, that's my little update, guys. That's my little rant as well. Let's pray before we go inside and destroy this workout, guys. I'm just going to see. No one's next to me. Okay, we should be good. All right. Hello, Goddess. Carlos speaking to you. Just want to say thank you so much for letting me wake up today, letting me breathe some fresh air today, God. Thank you for letting me talk to my brother, sister, mom, and dad today. Thank you so much for that. Thank you for keeping them safe, God. Thank you so much for that. Thank you for letting me eat my breakfast and, you know, just do the stuff that I gotta do today in order for me to be ready for the next day, God. Thank you for letting me wash clothes. Thank you for letting me do everything, you know, from eating to breathing to just showing up and, you know, a little bit spiritually getting better, God. Thank you so much. Please bless this workout. Please don't keep me safe and do what we gotta do for me to just grow mentally, physically stronger, spiritually, God. Please, I'm in your hands, and I do want you to help me, you know, and lean on me, and I want to lean on you, because, you know, in my life I haven't leaned on anyone the way I'm speaking to you and trying to lean on you, God. Please, I want you to, I want to believe in you, and I want to just be there by your side. You know, putting you first is a priority for me. I want to start doing that every single day, God. Amen. All right, guys. Let's go inside and let's just destroy this workout. All right, well, guys, we're about to start the workout. We're going to be doing 3 sets here. We're gonna start with the 25. Slowly get heavier. It's all pump work, guys. We're trying to get some blood flow in the chest, so let's just not worry about how heavy we're going. We just focus on the blood contact with the chest and the stretch. Good shit, guys. Let's get it. Oh, yes. That felt real good, baby. We got one more to go. We're gonna keep it here at 2 quarters on each side. No more heavy than this. Again, we're trying to get some blood in the chest. That's all we're doing. We're just trying to get ready for that first act. Holy cow, chest is about to explode here. Tight as a rock right now. But let's go do our first set of some incline dumbbells. All right guys, we already finished warming up here on the incline dumbbells. I did 50 pounds for like a set of 5 to 8. Nothing too crazy, just really wanted to get that a little bit more warm up before we hit the chest hard. Then we went to 80 pounds. We did that for like a good solid three reps. Just quickly get that, you know, the feel of the heavy weight. And now we're gonna go to our hundreds. The goal here is to do three sets. Anywhere from 8 to 12 reps. That is the goal. So let's just push and see how many we could get. I'm excited. I haven't touched the hundreds in a while, but I'm pretty confident I could do them pretty well now. So yeah, let's get this shit. Get this shit done, baby. Let's get this shit. Well, we did hundreds, but not expected where we wanted to. We got 5 reps. Damn, bro. I'm weak as shit. That was another 5. I already did push myself there for sure. Holy cow. Yeah. All right. That was it for the heavy stuff today. Now let's go on to the next workout, which is gonna be this bad boy right here. Let's go. Oh yeah. Ready, set. Keep pushing, guys. Fuck. Just push, guys. Just push. We added a plate and a quarter on each side, so we're not gonna go heavy on this one. We just want to, you know, push it and try to get the form as much as we possibly can. Just keep the form as best as we can. Kettle more. Holy cow, that hurts so much. Two more sets. Thank you. Ah. I couldn't get that shit off, baby. I just couldn't. All right, guys. I'm feeling a little bit spontaneous. We're going to be doing a little bit more chest flies. But we're going to be doing it with the actual cable machines this time instead of the plate-loaded cable flies. So there's a good three sets of those. And call it a day there for chest. After this. We still got triceps, so we're gonna do that as well. So let's get that out the way, guys, because man, I'm tired. Full fucking weight loaded, 140. I'm honestly so close to passing out off of just how tired I am, sleepy. So let's just push, bro. We just gotta really push here. Four sets. No tengo todo junto. So let's just finish strong, man. Finish strong. Proud of myself, and I'm proud of you. Whew, we got it through. We didn't want to be here. We didn't want to show up, man, but we did. That's just the most important thing. We showed up. Good shit, guys. We finished with the bang. Now, let's go home, get the last meal in, a scoop of protein, a yogurt in us, and that's it, call it a night. I'll see you guys at the house when we get there. It won't take long. We'll get there in a few. My camera battery died, but I just finished drinking my last protein shake, which was a protein smoothie. It was, not a smoothie, but just a protein shake. It was peanut butter cup. Just one scoop of this with water. That's it, that's all you need, guys. So once again, take care, stay safe. I love you, God loves you. Lose weight. Stop putting effort into yourself. Become the best version of yourself, guys. I'm really tired, really sleepy. I'm probably just gonna wash my face and go to sleep, guys. Honestly, I'm super tired. I'll see you guys tomorrow for another workout. It's gonna be our back and biceps. So if you guys are ready, see you guys tomorrow.